Welcome back to our channel Vaibhav e-learning academy. Today we are going to continue our topic ratio and proportion. This is our part number 5. In the previous video we have learned about some word problems additional things about word problems in ratio. I hope you have understood that topic. Today we are going to continue our topic, that is ratio and proportion. Now we are going to learn about proportion. What is a proportion first of all? Before going to that, let us take any ratio. For example, as we all know, ratio can be represented in two forms. One form is a fraction and one form is a ratio form. So let us take any example of a fraction. Let our fraction be A by B. This is one ratio, and C by D. A by B and C by D. These two are one ratio. Now, for example, if this A by D and C by D, if A and D are being multiplied, B and C are being multiplied, we get that is a proportion. But how can we express that? How can we say that this is a proportion? To say that, we have our formula that if A and B, a rational number, can be multiplied to a number, any constant number, n, we get the answer C by D. If we simplify the answer of C by D, we should get A by B. So if we get the answer A by B is equal to C by D, where C and D, if get cancelled, gets our answer as A by B, then we can say that A by B is proportional to C by D. Oh, what will I put in between? Can I put an equal sign? We can either put an equal sign or a double colon. So this is how can we represent a ratio. This is read as A by B is proportional to C by D, or A is to B is proportional to C is to D. So let us take any example. Let us take an example that A by B is 1 by 2 and our number M will be 3. If 1 is multiplied by 3 and 2 is multiplied by 3, we get 3 by 2, 3s are 6. If we simplify this, 3 times 1, 3 times 6, 3 times 2 is equal to 6. We get 1 by 2. That was the question we had the starting. If we get any problem like this, we can say that these fractions or ratios are proportional. So this was the basic introduction to what is a proportion. Now let us take that I have a proportion here. A is to B is proportional to C is to D. Here we have some terms to be noted. A is to B is proportional to C is to D. Here A and D are extreme terms. Extreme terms, as they are in the least, so they are extreme terms. A and D are extreme terms. B and C. B and C are middle terms. A and B are extreme terms. B and C are middle terms. Here, if the product of the extreme terms A and D, if it is equal to B and C, then also we can say that it is proportional. If our product A and D is equal to B and C, then also we can say that it is proportional. And there is one more way of telling whether it is proportional. If A by B and C by D are two ratios, the cross multiplication of these ratios will be getting AD. This one, B and C, will be getting BC. This was the rule which we had discussed in our first video about ratio. This was one of the points to remember. So let us take an example. A by B is 3 by 6 and C by D is 9 by 18. So if you multiply 3 into 18, we get 24. 3 8s are 24, balance 2, 3 1s are 3, 4 and 5, we get 54. And if we multiply 6 into 9, we get 54. 54 is equal to 54. So there are many ways you can get how is a ratio and how are two ratios, are they proportional or not. In simple, we can say that proportion is just equality of two ratios. Proportion explains whether two ratios are equal or not. That is a proportion. So far, let us take one example to understand about the proportion. We are taking one example, that is 3 is to 5 is proportional to 6 is to 11. Can we say that these both are proportional? There are many ways to represent, but we'll be using our formula. These are AB, these are CD. A into D is equal to B into C. A into D is equal to 3 into 11 should be equal to B into C is equal to 5 into 6. 3 into 11 is equal to 33 is equal to 5 to 3 is equal to 30. So the answer is 33 is not equal to 30. So we can say that these both ratios are not proportional to each other. If you want, we can even explain 3 by 5 is it equal to 6 by 11. 5 6 are 30, 3 11s are 33, which is not equal to each other. So we can say that these are not proportional. So we have taken some examples. So far we have learned about ratios and proportion. Now there may be a general question in our mind. How is ratio different from a proportion? Let us try to solve this answer with a quick table. Let us see. I have a table here, that is this table. This table shows the difference between ratio and proportion. What is proportion again? Proportion is only equality. Proportion is a thing which states the equality between two ratios. Now, what is the difference between ratio and proportion? So, we have some comparisons. We have just written two of them. We have more two comparisons we will be seeing later on. So, first one, meaning. Ratio. Ratio refers to the comparison of two same units. As said in the before videos, the units will be same. Whatever the number is, the units may be same. If we are given two different units, we just take the smaller unit. For example, we are given meter and kilometer, we take the smaller unit. So meter is the unit here. Ratio refers to the comparison of two units with set two value with same unit. Then we have proportion. What is a proportion? When two ratios are set equal, it is called a proportion. So we have taken one ratio as 2 by 3 and one ratio as 4 by 6. If you multiply 2 by 2, we get 4. If you multiply 3 by 2, we get 6. This is what a ratio is. 2 by 3 and 4 by 6 are proportional to each other. This is a proportion. And then we have, what does it represent? A ratio represents quantitative relationship between two categories. A category may be, like in the first video, we have taken an example of oranges and lemons. We have taken 8 oranges and 6 lemons. So, for every 3 oranges, like every 4 oranges, there were 3 lemons. So, there were two categories. One category was orange, one category was lemon. But what does the proportion say? Quantitative relationship of a category and a total. For example, we are inside a classroom. There are 15 boys, 20 girls. What is the total number? 35. 15 plus 20 is equal to 35. Then the ratio of boys to the total will be 15 is to 30. 15 is to 30 is 1 is to 2. So that is one category and another category. Here we have two categories, one and different. This is one total out of which one will have the proportion to the total one. For example, we have that 15 boys and 20 girls. Total were 30. Boys to the total will be 30 is equal to 1:2. So this is what a proportion represents. And then we have two more topics to discuss. Let us see what are those. So the first one is, third one is, what is it? What is it? A ratio is an expression. A ratio is an expression and a proportion is an equation. A ratio is an expression and a proportion is an equation. What is an expression? As said in the algebra playlist, expression means only the terms. Many terms formed together are expression. What is an equation? Equation stores the equality between two sides. So, two ratios, 2:3 and 4:6 are equal. So, this is an equation. As we said, we can either put this sign or an equal to sign. Both are same. So, if you put equal to sign, it is an equation and ratio is an expression. And the last one is, what do we call it? Or terms that we state. For our ratio, we use the term is two. Is two. And for proportional, is two can be a colon. How can we represent it? In a colon. And proportion we use proportional to. There are not only is two and proportional to, there are many ways in which we can pronounce these two things, but we are going to only focus on is two and proportional to. So I hope you have understood this topic about the proportion and the difference between ratio and proportion. See you next time with the next video. Thank you for watching my video. Please like my video, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you and goodbye.